We've started a new project in Sydney, which is really interesting. There's a growing trend in Australia for what have been called multi-generational houses. There's a few reasons why this is happening. Some of it's cultural. There's sort of people of Asian heritage that do it as part of their culture to have their parents join the family in later years. But also a huge part of it is issues of affordability. More and more housing is becoming impossible to buy for many people in places like Melbourne and Sydney and other places in Australia. So multi-generational houses become a great way to really share the financial burden. And also, as more and more families have both parents working, it means that the care of the children can be shared about. Creating complex mixes beyond the oversimplified nuclear family model is a great thing, no matter how you look at it. I'm all for diversity, and creating multi-generational housing is a wonderful thing. It can only make homes better. In this home, Helen has a wonderful brief. She works on a loom and has, you know, really enjoys her craft of working on the loom and even dyeing her own yarns. She's also got an extensive library. She's a reader and researcher. And she wanted to be able to be part of this family. So there's two parents, two boys, two young boys, and Helen in the house. And the trick so often with multi-generational housing is how do you deal with both connection and separation? How do you create a space that's adaptable enough so that they feel like they're part of it and that they're sharing in all of the fun times and the really good quality spaces, but then also able to slide a few panels shut, turn their back and have their privacy? And how do you have it so that nobody feels compromised in their space, as though the idea of the granny flat being just the shed out the back with a loo in it, how can you make sure that it's got a really good quality space to it? Another big thing too for Helen was that she likes having friends coming over, and that idea of imposing, you know, some of her friends, she said, felt like they were imposing as they entered the shared family space. They came over to see her, not to get in the way of the kids. So this has been really delightful in trying to work out how we can have this mixed family living together, but then also with just the sliding of a couple of large panels, Helen can have her own spot, her own street access as well, and she can have people coming and going without disturbing anybody else in the house. Sliding panels is a big way that we're dealing with that. We're also introducing these two garden spaces smack in the middle of the house, which we want to explore vertical sliding glass panels so that when you slide the panels upwards, you really do have trees growing in the middle of your lounge room. That means that Helen's space, which is at the front of the house, has this great garden that she can claim as her own depending on how she slides the panels that are around it. Or she can just close it off and get even more depth and protection, however you want to call it, away from the living space. So if the two young boys are going nuts and making heaps of noise, she can actually slide down, shut down a couple of surfaces. The owner is a builder. We really enjoy working with builders, making judgments of our own about the best ways of constructing or the best materials to use. It's really good to actually, at an early stage, be able to say to somebody, right, what are the materials that you are most confident with or that you most enjoy using or that you would like to use more, or that are the materials and systems that your crew likes using or that your tradies are more most accustomed to. And out of those discussions, you actually get to try new things. You often get to try new materials and new techniques, and it becomes a sort of a whole added layer of richness to the client-architect relationship, where you're not only briefing and chatting about the way that people want to live, the way that they want their spaces arranged, but actually how they also want to create it with their own hands. It's pretty amazing. Upstairs, you've got the two young boys and the parents, and all on one level and close by so that the boys don't feel separated from their parents. But actually, in terms of the way that the spaces are arranged, you turn right when you get to the top of the stair to go over to the parent zone, and you turn left against the kid zone. So there is this separation simply by sort of direction. But if one of the kids gets scared in the middle of the night, they can sort of run to the parents. But also, things change as time goes on. And as the kids get more independent, we actually made their zone so that, not dissimilar to Helen's, so that you can actually slide and rotate hidden panels that are in walls to add layers and depth from the rest of the house, so that they can be as connected or as removed from the rest of the action as they want. We think that corridors are typically wasted space, so where we have the corridor upstairs, that's where we've put the boys' study desk, and they'll have their robes and bookshelves and things like that, and then their bedrooms will have big sliding panels, which means that they can basically absorb that corridor space into their bedroom spaces, or it becomes part of one big shared space. So it's not just condemned to being a place that you stroll down every now and then, but it can actually be an activity hub. The entry of the house acts in a similar way, where you arrive and it's a shoes-off house. So when you arrive, there's a bench right at the front door, and you can sit down and take your shoes off. And then before you move into the house proper, so instead of it just being an entry corridor, it is actually a place where you sort of sit down, chill out, greet, meet. It's a lot more than just circulation. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Please feel free to leave a comment. This is the first design here, and we haven't gone to council with this yet, so we're most likely to get hell kicked out of the project. But let us know what you reckon, and hit that like button, and hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching. Bedroom. We've got it so the studio space can become a guest bedroom, and that's by having part of the cabinetry wall actually rotate out.